What's going on, folks? In this video, we're going to talk about how to create random strings in Python. So I'm going to go ahead and import two libraries to start off. I'm going to import random, and I'm going to import string. Alright, so say if string length let's make a function called get random string, and let's say string length equals 10 by default. Let's randomize the let's go ahead and we're not worried about the length just yet. Okay. What you can do is I imported string, and string has you have string dot ASCII lowercase, you have string dot ASCII uppercase. These are different ways to get a list of all the uppercase, all the lowercase letters available. There's string dot ASCII letters. There's string dot digits. And you also have string dot punctuation. Okay, so say if you can say your possible letters equals string dot ASCII lowercase print, and I'm going to use a join command with a blank string to start, so it's gonna join all the items in the list. With nothing in between them. So, blank string dot join. Random. Dot choice. Letters. For I in range 10. Alright, and that should do it to create and print out our random string of lowercase letters. That's 10 in length. Let's run that. And nothing happened because I didn't do anything, so let me call it. And run it. Got an error. Check out what's going on here. It says, where's length? Oh, I'm missing a parentheses here, random choice letters. And for I in range 10, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 1. There's too many parentheses closing. Okay. Now let's try to run it. And here's our string, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 characters. Now what if we wanted a random number of characters between 1 and 10, for example? We could do range 1, 11. And in range, let's do randint. I use random.choice to get a single letter out of the group of letters. And with this inline for loop, now we're using a random.randint between 1 and 11 characters long, which is, it's going to go from 1 to 10. Actually, randint will go from 1. It'll be, should be inclusive, so I'll use it like that. 1 to 10. I believe it's inclusive. So it should give you, let's run it. Check the parentheses here. Let's see if we need one more. Yep. Okay, we've got a four-letter word. Let's do if random integers from between 3, 5. Okay, got a three-letter word. Got a four-letter word. Got a three-letter word. Four-letter word. I'm not sure if it's including the last character, number 5. I think it's only, it might be only going from 3 to 4. Oh, there's 5. Okay, so it is inclusive, of course, like I thought. So it's creating a random lowercase string between 3, 4, or 5 letters. All right, now what if we wanted to use uppercase only? You can run it that way. I spelled uppercase wrong. And now we have a randomly between 3 and 5 letter word that's all uppercase. What if you wanted to mix your uppercase and lowercase letters? You could use ASCII underscore letters from the string library. And you're mixing here, CAW, lowercase a. What if you wanted to mix in some digits there, or just only digits? Let's do string.digits. And run it. And what if we wanted to do string.punctuation? We got a short string with just 3 characters. Little smiley face guy here. Let's make this longer. What if we had lowercase and punctuation? So punctuation plus string dot lowercase. And it's supposed to be ASCII lowercase. There we go. There's an S. There's a bunch of punctuation. And there's also an O in there. What if we wanted to do This is good for like, say, if you're making a random username, you could use lowercase and uppercase letters. If you're using a password field, you could throw in all of these together. So let's pretend we are creating a password. String dot, let's just copy all of these. I'm going to change these commas to pluses. So we'll go ahead and concatenate all these lists into one big list of different types of characters. And watch the magic happen when we run it. Okay, we got capital letters, we have a symbol, there's a number in there, a couple numbers. And we have, again, we're randomizing the length here from 3 to 10. So we have a random length. It's pretty cool. What if we wanted, for some reason, the password or the string we're generating you didn't want to have any repeated characters in it? So then you could change random.choice to random.sample. So I'm going to type these here as a comment. You have random dot choice, you have randint, and you have random dot sample. Those are your library functions we're using for random here. And so I changed choice, the word random dot choice, to random dot sample. And run it. Not sure why that didn't work. Choice. Let me look that up real quick, see if I can't figure that out. Anyway, yeah, I don't think that was gonna work anyway because it's using a for loop. But anyway, we did get it going with the most useful application of it, or most common application, where you don't mind duplicate letters. Hope you don't mind that. And let's see. Yeah, there's your code for how to generate a random string in Python. Using all kinds of different digits, punctuation, and letters of your choice. Also, you can randomize the length here, so a lot of different flexibility, and that's very good for testing or for any reason you'd want to create a random string using Python. And stay tuned for the next videos, and thanks for watching.